It's Captain Cheesehead. Boys and girls, I'm here today with my good friend and pal, Mr. Southerton.
What's up, boys and girls?
And today we're going to talk to you a little bit about Mini Lessons, Grammar in the Sentence, Part 3, Special Pronoun Section.
Pronouns? Awesome. I love pronouns.
Me too.
Captain Cheesehead, I want to just take a quick minute here. Between this packet and our last packet, I just want to give the boys a little heads up. I had a little accident, and I seem to have had a minor lesion of the left arm. And I'm doing okay, boys and girls. I don't want any of you to be upset or anything, but I just wanted to show that to you so that, you know, if you saw me during instruction and wondered what happened, I just want to let you know that I'm okay.
You're a very tough man, Mr. Southerton. I am proud of you.
Captain Cheesehead is proud of me? Wow!
Mr. Southerton, why don't you take the boys and girls through this overview of the packet?
Okay, Captain Cheesehead.
First of all, this is a little bit of a preview, Grammar Unit 3, preview, pronouns. The first thing that we're going to talk about is that sentence part identification chart. Boys and girls, it's not going away. It's this thing right here. It's in your third packet as well as your first and second packet. This is the framework of our sentences. And we're going to see if this gets a little more intense as time goes on. But it's also going to help us out a great deal with these pronouns. Going back to our packets, we're going to have lots of information, lots of it. And these pronoun information sheets are all in this packet. And they talk about each one of the following situations.
And for what it's worth, boys and girls, I typed them all up by myself with one arm.
Subject forms of personal pronouns will be our first page. We're going to work on that one today. Object forms of personal pronouns will be next. Possessive forms, that's showing ownership. Interrogative, pronouns used to ask questions. We're going to talk about demonstrative pronouns, this, that, these, those, indefinite pronouns. Those are ones that you're not sure about the person. So you might use anyone or someone or everyone. Lots of issues that we'll discuss with indefinite pronouns and unique pronoun situations. Things such as, when do I say we boys or us boys? There is a difference. Moving down through this, here's the information. Two sheets worth. You can see, if we look right here, that we have subject forms like I and you and he and she. Those are all singular, it. And then the plural ones, we, you, and they. We also have the object forms and the possessive forms.
Captain Cheesehead?
Yes, Mr. Southerton?
That's my arm. You're using my arm as a pointer.
Relax, Mr. Southerton. It's merely a flesh wound. You'll be fine.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll be fine. Sorry about that, Captain Cheesehead. I've been kind of looking for it a little bit recently, and just be kind of nice to know where I was.
Well, now you do know, so go back to your corner.
Yes, of course, I'll go back to my corner.
Now, as I go down through this a little bit more, there are all the explanations right there of the different pages that we'll be doing, and then they will be individualized on those pages. So there's one packet, or two pages, I should say, that shows an overview of all these different things. And then all of these things will be broken down into individual pages, as we'll see right here with personal pronouns, like the subject forms or nominative case. It says right here, the subject forms of pronouns are used in place of nouns when the nouns are simple subjects or predicate words. As I showed you earlier, up above, subject forms, I, you, he, she, it. Don't say that too quickly there. He, she, it. And the plural forms, we, you, and they. All these things would be used in place of a simple subject and after a linking verb as a predicate word, predicate pronoun. So let's look at two examples. Would I say he or him sent her the bouquet of roses? This sounds right, and it is right. I chose he instead of him, since he falls in the subject position. He, SS, simple subject, action verb sent, and then roses would be the direct object, and her would be the indirect object. Next example, this shows us the other situation, where I use subject forms, right up here, all my subject forms, in place of a predicate word. Who lost the pencil? It must have been he or him. Now, it sounds like I should say it must have been him. He's the one that looks guilty. It must have been him. But I would actually say it must have been he. Because he, as we see right up here, is a subject form. And it's following this linking verb, been. Must have been. It would be the subject, predicate pronoun, he. It must have been he. If you're unsure of that, well, sometimes it's okay to just sort of, you know, in your head, use a little bit of a British accent. Who lost the pencil? It must have been he. See, those British people, they all speak that correctly. And it sounds right when they say it. But when we Americans say it, it just sounds kind of stupid. But it's still the right way.
It must have been he.
Oh, it must have been he. Yeah, the British people, they got it down. They got some swag. Anyway, try that every once in a while when you're confused about these subject forms in place of predicate pronouns. Predicate words. Here we go. Practice. In the sentence below, underline the correct word choice. You must circle prepositional phrases and label the sentence parts to assist you. So as I look at this, number one, us or we ran for 3 miles after school. I circle the prepositional phrases, and as I see this, I'm looking for a main verb, and I have a main action verb, ran. Who or what is this about? It's about we, the simple subject. And if I keep coming up here, I can see that my subject forms are shown. I'd have to choose we instead of us. Us would be that object form in this situation. They or them, number two, are crazy for you. Prepositional phrase shown right there. Linking verb. I'm going to have some issues, I think, getting these things to come over. There, I think I got it. Linking verb are. Who or what are, I'd have to say, they. They falls in place of the simple subject. Wow, that's just not really cooperating too well for me at all. But they would be the simple subject in this case, and crazy would be my predicate adjective. All right, so they was the correct choice. This first one was we. So we're having some technical difficulties there. We'll just sort of cross that out. Let's go to number three. I or me cannot believe that we lost that game. Kind of getting ahead of ourselves. We have a main clause here and we have a dependent clause here. Let's just not worry too much about this right now. Let's just get to the situation. I or me cannot believe this thing that we lost that game. That whole thing is like a direct object. Anyway, believe is going to be my main action verb. Hopefully I can find a main action verb over here. Bring that down. And can is going to be my helping verb. Not, but can. And I'm really having some issues here. I'm going to pause this, boys and girls, and hopefully get back to the situation at hand. So I believe I'm still recording here. I pause and try to clean a few things up. So as I look at this, can believe is my helping and main verb. Who or what can believe? And I am in the subject position. I can believe this situation that we lost that game. I cannot believe it. Next one. Number four. Her or she is so adorable. No prep phrase. Is my main linking verb. Who is this about? It's about she. She might be taking the place of Sally's name. Sally is so adorable. So that's what pronouns do. They take the place of nouns. She is so adorable. Number five. By the way, adorable would be a predicate adjective in this case. Number five. Him or he can't be serious. No prepositional phrase. My main linking verb, be. I do have a helping verb here. Can. Not can't, but can. Who or what can be serious? Again, I might use Jack. Jack can't be serious. Fred. Fred can't be serious. Maybe I need a pronoun in place of his name. Would I choose him or he? Since it's on the subject form, I would choose he. He can't be serious. Now, those sound well. They sound good, and they do work out well. But the ones that are tricky, again, are these predicate words that are predicate pronouns. Look at number six. The main loser in the whole contest was me or I. Prepositional phrase in the whole contest. Linking verb was. Try this again. Was, linking verb. Who or what was? This is about the loser. And now I'm linking loser to a word in the predicate. And the loser was, predicate pronoun, I. I would be the correct choice. Wanted to go back up to this previous one. Sorry about that. He can be serious, predicate adjective. So getting back to number six, the loser was I. Number seven. It could not have been them or they. Keep in mind I'm going off of this pool of words. These pronouns. I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they. So they is a subject form, and I have to use it in place of a predicate pronoun. It could not have been them or they. I do have a main linking verb, been, helping verb, gotta try that again, main linking verb, been, gonna pause again, boy, this is being really thick. Boys and girls, we're having technical difficulties. We just received the message about Adobe Reader not working, so we're gonna do number seven over. As you can see, some of what we previously did was lost, but it shouldn't be that big of a problem. It could not have been them or they. Once again, as I look at this, let me get this down. As I look at this, been is going to be my main linking verb. Have is going to be a helping verb. Not is not a helper. But could is, could have been. It is going to be my subject. And it could have been them or they. And I have to choose they because they is the predicate pronoun. The guilty people were we or us. No prep phrase. Were is my main linking verb. People would be my simple subject. What kind of people? Guilty people. There's an adjective there. And sticking with the framework of the sentence, I'm now looking for that predicate pronoun, and I have to choose we instead of us. The guilty people were we. Predicate pronoun, we. I know it was she, or I know it was her. No is going to be my main action verb, and really we have this thing in here where it was her or she,
That's kind of acting as its own, going to say its own clause. So let's just pretend it says it was her or she, and I'm going to go from there. Was would be a main linking verb in that clause. It would be the simple subject, and I'd have to choose for the predicate pronoun she. I knew it was she. And number 10, it was I or it was me. Who broke the window? It was me. Well, that's what some people would say here in America. But again, you go through this, was main linking verb. That's not going to work. Let's just sort of delete that. It would be the simple subject, and since it's a predicate pronoun, I would say it was I. Who broke the window? It was I. See? You got to use that British accent. Who broke the window? It was I. So you can see we have all 10 of them right there. We did lose some of our answers before, but if you look at this, I would definitely have to say I for number 3, she for number 4, he for number 5. The main loser was I for number 6. I think the rest pretty much fall into place. Well, from my end, that was a little adventurous, but I think we got the message across. And I don't feel like for the fourth time trying to redo this. So, I'm good with it. How about you, Captain Cheesehead?
Yes, Mr. Southerton, it certainly wasn't perfect, and we did have some major technical difficulties, but I think you handled it quite well, especially considering you only have one arm.
Well, Captain Cheesehead, actually, I have two arms. Remember, one's on your pointer.
Captain Cheesehead, over and out.